VirtualCon 3 was a mess! Let's talk about it. Welcome to the Gastlecast. I'm Chris.
I'm Heather. Well,
in this episode, we're going to talk about the disaster that was VirtualCon 3.
Endless trash!
Well, just like we thought, Funko.com didn't hold up for VirtualCon 3.
Based off the recent drops, this does not shock me at all.
Even though the site's not that great, I have some thoughts on why it was so horrible. And we'll talk about that toward the end of this video. Now, of course, in this video, you know we're going to have a whole bunch of comments as well. We've been digging up good comments all day long. You know, most people are ready to get rid of their entire Funko collection right now. But that's not going to stop people from continuing to buy. They're going to continue collecting. It never ends.
One good thing is that we were able to get all of the Funko Pops that we wanted from Funko.com.
Heather and I have two completely different experiences when it comes to VirtualCon 3. I was on a laptop with Ethernet hardlined in from my router into the computer. I went on the website as soon as the shop opened up, and I selected my two items that I wanted. I went straight to cart, hit the Amazon Pay button, and bing, bang, boom, I was out of there in about 20 minutes, which is a very short length period of time compared to everybody else.
Yeah, my experience was a lot different than that, and a lot slower. I was on my phone on Wi-Fi, and I opened Funko.com as soon as everything went up. I put four items in my cart, and I sat in line forever. Once it finally brought me out of line and up to the pay button, I hit Amazon Pay, and it completely destroyed everything. I had to go and re-wait in line. After waiting in line for a really long time, I was finally able to put my information in, and then I got hit with that shipping circle. And it was spinning and spinning and spinning for about 30 or 40 minutes. Finally, when I got through, only three of the Funko Pops were still in my cart, so I was only at $45 instead of $60. I didn't hit the $50 for free shipping, but I was not about to chance it and go back and add something else to my cart, so I just spent the $6.95 or whatever in shipping. But I did finally get through, after waiting forever.
A lot of other people shared our frustrations, and they took it to Facebook and other social media apps. And as always, we collected some comments for your pleasure. Everything sold out. Nice job, Funko. Glad you were able to ensure your loyal fan base was taken care of. Can't even get the shipping option to work correctly. But at the end of the day, Brian gets his millions from us sheep. So why bother, right?
Here comes the money.
Here we go. Money.
Wasted my time again, Funko.
Done. Funk off. Doing this 7 years plus now and it's pointless.
If I lose the pops in my cart, I will be done with this company.
Funko is the boyfriend that beat you, apologizes, and swears that they changed. It'll never happen again. And then here we go again with a black eye and split lip.
Well, that is a really good analogy, but holy crap. I'm done with Pops. Should have never got in the game. I'm done. F you, Funko, and all your incompetent staff. Thanks for nothing. Your IT department is a joke.
We need a class action against Funko LLC and Shopify LLC. There is no equal access. The bots get everything. Prepare for a lawsuit.
So, inquiring about a class action lawsuit tomorrow against the good old Funko shop.
Just change your name to Co. Lose the fun.
Okay, normally compensation is offered for wasting the time of thousands of people.
So obviously fans are angry, and it makes sense. But does it make sense to go as far as to say you're going to have a class action lawsuit against Funko? I mean, isn't that a little too much? I never understand why people take to social media to leave a bunch of these nasty comments. I mean, they literally lead nowhere. They just make you look silly. We've said this time and time again.
But again, don't stop doing it because we love it.
People take this stuff so personally, and I don't understand it. I understand being upset and being bummed out over not getting a Funko Pop, but being this angry about it to leave these kind of comments? Okay, changing the name to Co and dropping the fun is pretty funny. I gotta admit that.
Yeah, that was like my favorite one.
Everybody's blaming bots, but I don't think bots are the only reason why we had such a mess. Here are my top three reasons I think Funko.com had such an issue during VirtualCon 3.
Number one, everyone was at home. You have to keep in mind, SDCC didn't actually happen this year, so the hundreds and thousands of people that would have bought these pops at the con were at home too, just like us.
Typically when a con's going on and a Funko shop drop happens, the people at home are ordering. The people at the con usually can't order. Reception's horrible. Every Funko collector attacked that website at one time. That can't be easy on the website. The website had to have been chugging along. which explains why it took such a long time for us to purchase the things that we wanted. Which is my second reason. The website was bombarded by traffic. Too much traffic. Shopify couldn't handle all that. My third reason, it's because of the time that this drop occurred. The drop occurred for us on the East Coast at 8 p.m., which is a really prime time to go on and buy stuff.
And for the West Coast, it was 5 p.m. Most people are off work by then.
Typically, this occurs during a weekday, during the day, when everybody's at work. And people complain, oh my God, I'm at work, I wasn't able to get it. Well, in this case, everybody was home and they were able to get on their personal computer and put their orders in. All those orders going in all at one time, the pipe is only so big. It can only accept a certain amount of traffic. No wonder the website was having such a hard time. So we can't blame a bunch of botters. Yeah, of course, I'm sure a couple of botters got in here and there, maybe more than I think. But it wasn't a complete bot problem. I can totally assure you of that. Could Funko.com get better? Of course it could. I think the functionality of it was a little bit better than the last couple of drops we've seen. So before we go and blame bots, let's just talk about the traffic, the amount of people that wanted these things. People are not at San Diego Comic-Con this year, so they want these exclusives. Everybody and their brother was on there to get those exclusives. For a big drop, it was inevitable that this was going to happen. The site just needs to have more improvements. I think we're getting there. I think slowly but surely, Funko.com is getting better. Guys, did you get everything you wanted at VirtualCon 3? Are you bummed out? Do you wish you could have gotten more? Let us know all that and more in the comment section down below. Do you want to join an awesome collectible group on Facebook? Well, head over right now and join Gastlecast-WeHuntTogether. It's a great group full of great people talking about collectible things. So go and check it out right away. All right, guys, that time again. Remember, as always, we hunt together, yes. We'll catch you next time.
Bye.